pleasure to be here as a wife among you. I'm here because I believe that in order to create a better world, we need to believe in one. I think it's quite common nowadays to hear the view that the system is broken and that the system is unfair and toxic. What's less common is a belief that there can be a better way, that a general helplessness and apathy. I want to challenge that. I think apathy serves to benefit the status quo. And we've got to be very clear about something. This system is working exactly how it's intended to work. This system is benefiting the elite few who have structured it carefully to hand them all the money, all the power, and all the wealth. And what we're facing now is the perfect outcome of that. So when we say this system is broken, let's just change that to this system is working perfectly. It's just fucking shit. Now, I think it is so shit because at the heart of it, we have very questionable goals. Our politicians go on constantly about GDP, don't they? GDP, they love GDP. Where was the meeting where we all decided that GDP was the goal of humanity? Fuck GDP, I wasn't at that meeting. GDP and profit are not sacred. Human well-being and the environment that isn't fucked are sacred. So I think we've really got to start challenging the goals that lie at the heart of the system. If we don't start, like, basically, we need to start valuing new goals. We need to say that every human being on this planet, regardless of income, colour, sexuality or ability, deserves equal opportunities and the right to happiness, health and education. What I fear most about what's happening right now is that those in power are turning life which I think is so precious and amazing, into an economic struggle. They are creating a two-tier society where only those at the top will be able to take advantage of opportunities. And they're doing this in many ways. They are eroding our basic rights. They are basically making it illegal for us to protest. They are removing the NHS as we speak. They are attacking education. And they are saddling us all with debt. By the way, the more of us in debt there is, the more GDP goes up. So that's how shit that is. And debt, of course, is a brilliant way of controlling people. If you imagine the next generation of students coming out with 50 grand plus of debt, how are they going to be able to engage and demand better? Debt is such an insidious form of control. And ultimately, the bigger aim is this, to reduce people's expectations so they don't believe they deserve a good life. We need to fight back. We all deserve that. I really do believe that we have the power, and that's why those in power are so scared of us, and they are attempting to dismantle the unions and anything which brings us together, because they know that we have the power. What's hard sometimes is to remember that we have the power and to come together. Because one of the primary tactics of the elite is divide and rule, to demonise our neighbours, students, immigrants, disabled people, welfare claimants. Actually, that's just such such a cynical tactic, because we need to come together. We need to realise the real problem at the heart of the system is a system that is unjust and a system which exists on exploitation and mass suffering. And we need to believe that we can do better. So I think it's so vital that we keep hope. Hope is so hard to have, and sometimes I sit at home and I feel overwhelmed by the awful nature of where we are. You know, we're facing environmental destruction. We may be the one species in the history of Earth to wipe themselves out. And wipe out many other species too. So it's not hard to feel overwhelmed and to feel helpless in tackling these issues. But I think we've got to look back over history, and we've got to realise that every right that we enjoy now was won by people like us coming together and believing in better. So I just want to end by saying, keep believing in better and keep viewing everybody as a human being with an equal right to happiness and fulfillment. Thank you.